Now at this stage, I'm going to run a sample program to show you how fast the CNC machine moves. The first thing it's going to do, it's going to call the carousel, and the program selects which tool it's going to choose. In this case, it's choosing tool M6, which has a designation on the carousel. Now once the tool has been selected, the head will traverse down to a safe distance that you've actually programmed so that it won't interfere with any other material in the part. As you can see, the bed moves. Now traversing to a safe part. When it gets to a safe level, the bed is now going to move, and it's moving in conjunction with the program. So what would happen here, if the material was here, the bed now moves to the tool and the cut starts. So if you could imagine there's a piece of material here, it's now cutting through the tool in the shape that we wanted. You can control the feed rate and the spindle speed manually, also has been set in the program. And you also, it must be watched over by the user at all times so that if a problem does arise, you can automatically stop it. And you run, that will run through its full cycle. Depending on the part, how complex it is, it could take anything up to 5 minutes to an hour. As I turn up the feed rate, the bed actually moves a little bit quicker and the spindle speed of the tool has increased as well. In real life, you would add lubrication because as the cutter is cutting the material, a lot of friction is generated. The more friction and heat will reduce in a rougher cut on the material. So we use special lubricants to cool the material and also protect the integrity of the tool. At any time, you can go back into manual mode. As a safety feature, if the door is ever opened, everything will cut off so that there's no chance of an injury to the user, that the machine will be running, nobody can put their hand in and have an injury. And that's the basic function of the CNC machine.